What we have here is a very small rocket mass heater. So there's a wood feed underneath this rock. Put your wood in, the fire burns sideways, there's a heat riser, goes down, goes in a loop through under my butt, and then up through this pipe. But this has some extra special stuff on it too. There's a hole right here. And we can do all kinds of cooking over that hole. So this is designed to be primarily for cooking, like a little outdoor barbecue kind of a thing. When we run it, what comes out of the hole is extremely clean. Totally clear, no smoke. Because, of course, since it's using the rocket stove variation. But most rocket stoves have a problem in that their heat riser is only this tall. So this one's got a heat riser that's this tall. And because of that, then it can burn all the smoke and burn all the other stuff, and we get a very clean burn. So we do two things here. One is to use this as a cooker, and we can cook all kinds of stuff on the surface. But we also use it as a smoker. We'll stick little bits of apple branches and apple wood in here, and it'll smoke that apple wood and get the smoke up into the smoker.
My name's Matt, and today I'm going to be assembling a rocket stove cooking unit. Outdoor cooker, patio heater.
So this is more insulation.
So you burn the fuel entirely, And we do that in a way that it's insulated so that that heat stays, burns all the fuel, and by the time it comes out of the top, it's pretty much not only completely burned, but it hasn't lost any heat. Then once we've burned all the fuel, then we can harvest the heat. And the best way to burn all the fuel is to have very low mass in the combustion chamber. And so There's sort of two stage things. You got the combustion zone and then the use zone. You can see how that's different than like your normal barbecue or even a normal wood stove, where you're kind of like warming yourself off the fire itself, right? So that's counterproductive to a clean burn because it's throwing heat away from the fuel at the time when it needs it to combust. We're pretty much done. Almost. I'm going to go get one more piece of that insulation to put on top of the burn tunnel before I bury that. And then we just put this thing over the top and it's done, it's ready to cook. It's not really ready to cook because we're gonna burn the mold out, but you know,
cool.
For the most part. And then this is the same as this, and it's formed ceramic fiber, and its function is to insulate.
Mm-hmm.
We put a little fiberglass tape on it.
Yeah.
I did that to try and, like, usually these crack, almost always, any of them.
Yeah.
For bricks, whatever.
Just like a little bit of rebar in there.
Exactly. And so the rebar, people always wanna use metal, but its expansion and contraction is different than this, so it'll tear it apart. So I found that this stuff does just kind of gives it a little mesh. You know, like if this were to crack, hopefully it won't fall in there now.
Yeah.
Right? So, and like I said, if I were to do this wet, it would kind of be like an arch in the sense that like it could be totally broken apart, but it can't go anywhere. Hole in the bottom of this.
Yeah.
Right? I cut it open.
Yeah. Made it big.
Yep. It's a little bit bigger than that one. And so for you cooks, this is your temperature. And your smoke, your smoking fuel is gonna go kind of like that. And I expect it to smoke like a bastard and be nasty. You come out the top and...
Oh, and it's got to burn out the coal.
Yeah.
The
coal, so it's going to be a mess.
What does it say? 166.
So that's pretty good.
If you like this sort of thing, come on out to the forums at permies.com, where we talk about rocket mass heaters, homesteading, and permaculture all the time.